My colleague Dean Sutter and I were asked by MPI to go and measure crayfish to see if we could find any sort of effect from the earthquake. Of course, when we got there, we found this landscape that was totally bizarre. I could see bull kelp way out of the water, and I thought that I was there at very low tide, but of course, it wasn't low tide at all. It was the tide was 3/4 in. So, over the course of the time that we were there, we could smell the seaweed going off, and there were lots of dead cook's turbans, dead starfish, thousands of limpets, queen power, and blackfoot power, and even the odd fish. We were finding rocks way out of the water, and territory where the crayfishermen were telling me that's where we used to set our pots. They put us on a rock platform, and we walked around and took photos. And when I got back into the boat, the skipper of the boat, who had been fishing there for about probably 40 years, said to me, "We used to drive over these rocks at high tide. And we'll never do that again. The territory's completely changed, and they're now going to have to go and explore the territory and relearn where the crayfish have gone." There's a long road to hoe for them, and of course they're dealing with all the earthquake issues. Houses that aren't functional, and you just really got a feel for them.